Hello everyone. My name is Loris Valenti. I'm the Vice President for the Microcontroller and Digital Product Groups in the Americas region. I welcome you to this afternoon session, and I hope you also have enjoyed our morning session. We have presented our offering in the sensors, and this is an impressive offering. All these sensors are able to capture data a little bit everywhere in the environment surrounding us. Then we will have the problem to manage and control all this data. So this is why we are here talking about embedded and connectivity technologies. So let's see where you can find our product. Basically, ST with its embedded processor with our microcontroller family of products is present everywhere there is a need of performance, connectivity, or security. Here we have some example of the application that we are addressing today. And as you know, our world is changing very rapidly. Never like today, our life have seen a dramatic change. And ST wants to be part of this change. ST wants to be able to simplify our life thanks to our products. Okay, so let's see. So looks like most of you is coming from the, is attending from the West Coast, even if we have a good participation a little bit everywhere. And thanks to our colleagues in Europe, it's very late for you. Thank you very much for participating. So our world is changing very, very rapidly, and the complexity of our world is increasing. So we can measure the complexity simply by looking at the amount of functions the objects that we use today are performing. So this is also reflected, as you see in this chart, but in the trend for the embedded processing market trends. So you see that the forecast is showing that in the next 3 years, this market will grow 8%. Actually, the microcontroller will grow a little bit lower than 6%, and the MPUs will grow about 13%. This is a clear indication of the need to have more computing power, more processing capabilities. At the base of this need, there is application like 5G with the IoT pervasion. There is new application enabled by security and, of course, artificial intelligence on the edge. How is ST playing in this field? Of course, this is a very important field for ST. So we have grown incredibly in the last 12 years. We moved from position number 11 to position number 2 worldwide with our microcontroller family of products. And all this has been done organically, so with no acquisition. Our STM32 family of products is made of more than 1,600 part numbers. We have today a customer base which is above 60,000 customers worldwide, and we ship more than 4 billion units. We have recently, last year actually, entered the MPU arena. With our STM32 MP1, we are addressing the needs of higher performances of Linux operating systems. So when we talk about STM32, basically we talk, as I said, about a wide, very wide family of products, ranging from value line, single core, low power devices to very high performance devices with multiple memory interfaces and different memory sizes. There is a common denominator in our family of products, which is that we want to address more security, more intelligence, and more connectivity. And you will see in the presentation today how we are doing this. We also provide with our products also complete solution addressing what we call verticals, applications like graphics, connectivity, security, wireless, motor control, digital power, and audio. These are the initial start for our support to full system solution, but of course we are growing this continuously. Now, in this context, we started last year an expansion, a dramatic expansion of our family of products, addressing the key areas I was mentioning. So when we talk about more performances, we basically introduced the MP1 family of product, our first MPU, and also the H7. STM32H7 is a dual-core microcontroller with embedded flash that can provide significant performances. We have then entered in the wireless connectivity area. This is done with a WB product that supports Bluetooth connectivity. It is a single core, single die, dual core with embedded radio. And then we also started addressing the need for security with our L5 family of products that is certified with the most stringent standards. Now, this was last year. This year, we further expanded the family of products. So for the MP1, we increased performances. For the wireless connectivity, we introduced the WL, which is a single die product for the LoRa connectivity. And then we also introduced security software packages. We announced our ecosystem to support, to better support artificial intelligence development, and also graphic development. So in our wide ecosystem, we also offer hardware solutions. So we have boards available, readily available, that can support you in the evaluation of the products, in the development of your application, and even the prototyping. All this is supported by the by a wide network of field application engineers and also distributors and partners. We also have an extensive offering in terms of training material on our website, and more than ever, we are announcing this with videos and with presentation that will help you get started on our products. So here we have another poll. So we would like to hear from you. It's very important for us to understand what is the key elements when you have to choose your next generation of MCU and MPUs. So this will be very useful for us to understand how to better address your needs. So we were talking about connectivity. So connectivity is a big part of our offering. And so in the Bluetooth area, as I said, we have the WB product that is supporting multiple protocols, including Thread X and Zigbee. And then we have the LoRa offering with the WL. So in terms of Bluetooth, we support the traditional application where you have a host connected to multiple devices, or we can support mesh networks where multiple devices are connected together. This is typical in home automation or smart home. We have also support for, sorry, we also have support for applications that have a need for a longer distance. In this case, we have the LoRa for lower bandwidth. LoRa is addressing application in the industrial field, agriculture, lighting, smart metering, or we can also support higher bandwidth with LTE, Cat-M, NB-IoT, and 5G certified solutions. So we don't have to forget that in our wireless connectivity offerings, we also have the ST25 family of products. This is a very interesting family of product addressing NFC. And more recently, we have certified this family for automotive so that you can develop applications like doors lock and lock or console pairing. Okay, so let's see the results of the poll. So looks like the wide majority of you is looking at the ecosystem when choosing the next generation of MCU and MPU. This is not coming as a surprise, and in fact, you will see in our presentation our ecosystem offering is very wide, and it's basically a comprehensive system that will enable you to address all the needs within the same tools. Now, it's time to wrap up for me and then leave the word to my colleagues. So we have seen that all the sensors that we have, all they need to capture data from our surrounding world requires management of this data, and we need to connect this data. So this is why with our microcontroller family, we want to offer you more computing power. This is done through our MPU or dual core microcontroller. We want to offer you more intelligence thanks to our Cube AI solution that will enable you to develop artificial intelligence products. More connectivity, wireless connectivity with WB supporting Bluetooth, WL supporting LoRa, or more performing solution with NB-IoT or CAT-M solution. We also have more security with our L5 family of products. And all this, as I was mentioning, is supported by the common ecosystem. So you don't have to worry about moving from one family of product to the other. The ecosystem and the tools are all the same. We also have a broader support, wide support, thanks to our field application engineers and partners. So I will leave you now to the afternoon session with a more detailed presentation from my colleagues talking about the main areas of our focus, artificial intelligence on the edge, developing GUIs with our products and micros, having a secure connection, exploring more wireless connectivity, and involved in the area of sub-gigahertz, 2.4 gigahertz, and also NFC. So I would hand over to Boone for the continuation of the day, and thank you very much for joining.
Great. Thank you, Loris. Thanks for the great overview. And it's clear that ST have been investing and is investing in the right products and technology for the growing market trends. And that will segment us into the next first session for the afternoon, which is bringing AI to the edge. But before that, while Marcus gets ready, I want to mention this is the virtual page that I talked about earlier. Here you can see the address here is st.com/July14virtual. There is a QR code here for a quick scan to get to the page. On this page, you will find the presentation that will be used today, as well as the product information page, and also at the bottom will be some for the demos itself. And so you'll have this. We'll have this post throughout the presentation. So with that, I'm going to pass.